The numbers are on a knife edge, according to our latest One News Kantar Public Poll. There's been no budget bounce for Labor or the Prime Minister, but it's not all rosy for National either. Political editor Jessica Mutch-Mackay has the numbers.
The post-budget sweeteners haven't given Labor an energy boost in the polls. Let's take a look at the numbers and see how they compare with our last poll in March. National is steady on 39. Labor is on 35, dropping 2. The Greens are up slightly on 10. ACT is down slightly on 7, while the Māori Party is steady on 2. Now let's look at some of the parties that aren't in Parliament. The Opportunities Party is on 2, and New Zealand First and New Conservative get 1 each. So translating that to seats in Parliament now. National gets this big blue chunk, 51 seats. Add in 9 from ACT and you get 60, just shy of the 61 needed to form a government. They'll need to party Māori and it would take a bit of convincing. On the other side, there are 45 red seats for Labor plus 13 green seats. 58 isn't enough. If the Māori Party joined the left, it would be 60 apiece and a hung parliament. So it's very, very close. Now let's look at the preferred Prime Minister numbers. Jacinda Ardern is in the lead on 33, down 1 from March. There's no change for the National leader, he's steady on 25. David Seymour has dipped and now sits on 3. Green MP Chloe Swarbrick isn't even a party leader but is sitting on 2. And Winston Peters is still registering on 1. So that's how the post-budget numbers have landed.
Selling New Zealand on the US stage and winning applause with the locals. But it's support back here that counts, and that's dipping in our latest poll.
The budget came at a time where we've got some really critical issues to address.
Digging into our poll numbers, Labor hasn't traditionally seen budget bounces, and despite spending billions, they didn't get one this time either.
The government spent a record amount of money, the most that was ever been spent in the history of New Zealand.
We are in a tough patch as well as the rest of the world.
Not such a tough patch for National, but the party and leader have plateaued.
You know, it's positive and encouraging. We've got real momentum over the last 6 months.
Do you have momentum though? Because you're stagnating on these numbers.
Well, we do. I mean, I think we've been making great progress and great momentum.
They need a tad more momentum to be able to do it with just National and ACT.
We're edging closer to a change of government where ACT plays a significant role.
Would you like to be Deputy Prime Minister?
I'd be very happy to serve as Deputy Prime Minister, but that's not my priority.
But the Māori Party is imagining a world where it's in the power position.
I jokingly said to Debbie, you can be Deputy Prime Minister and I'll be Co-Prime Minister. No, we haven't thought about that.
If the numbers fall this way on election night, Te Pāti Māori may even leave it to National and ACT to be ministers and try and get wins by supporting them in the House.
We've found that to be in an opposition from the crossbenches has been quite a powerful position for us to be in.
With the Prime Minister away with COVID, the Climate Change Minister was in the spotlight in Budget Week, his party bucking the trend.
We are amongst some of our best polling results ever, and I'm really delighted about that because it's very unusual for a support party like us to have our support rise during the course of a term in government with a larger party.
Jacinda Ardern is still most popular, and not just with these guys.
Are you committed to contesting the next election?
Yes, I'm not going anywhere.
But with 11% not sure how they'll vote, all the parties will be trying to sniff out support as election year looms.
All right, Jess is here with us now. Jess, yes, a year out from the election, but if this plays out like this, this is a potentially unusual situation with a hung parliament. What does that mean in practice?
If we do end up with that unusual situation where we have a 60-60 split, then it might end up that parties have to go to the Governor-General and say we can't form a government and we have to have another election. I was speaking to a constitutional expert today, Andrew Geddes, and he says it shows just what a dumb idea it is, having an even number of seats in this situation. I think it would be very rare for us to end up like that, but the takeaway from this is that things are tight when we're 18 odd months out from an election.
You mentioned the last poll. 8 weeks ago we sat here, we delivered pretty much similar numbers. What do you read into that?
I think that's interesting in itself. We are polling regularly, and with National we've seen it chipping away at that support, gaining bit by bit. With Labor this year, we've seen three polls. We've seen them go from 40, 37, now 35 tonight. I know that behind the scenes, Labor will be feeling like they're doing a bit better than this, and that's because of the polling period. We've had the Prime Minister over in the US. She does well on the world stage. And we've also had time for people to absorb that big budget spend, including the $350 for a lot of Kiwis.